Okay, good morning all of you. Today we are going to discuss about the information capacity. Very, very important topic for 4 months. That is information capacity. Okay, so first of all, what is meant by information capacity? In that information capacity, what type of data we are preferring? What type of data we are preferring? How the data which is conveyed? Okay. Likewise, we need to discuss about the information capacity. Okay. See, all of you know what is meant by information. Information means message. Everybody knows. Okay. So that means that message may be analog form, digital form, or any another form. Okay, but information capacity. That means what is meant by information capacity means the information capacity is, listen carefully, information capacity is a measure of how much information can be propagated. Information capacity is a measure of how much information can be propagated through a given communication channel, and that information is in the form of time and bandwidth that will be measured in terms of bits per second. That is represented as the information capacity. That is represented as a information capacity. See, the information capacity is a measure of how much information, a measure of how much information can be propagated through a communication system. That information is a function of bandwidth and transmission time. That is a function of bandwidth and transmission time. Okay, see here, this information capacity basically represents in the form of digital data. That is in terms of the bits. That is binary information. That means that is ones and zeros. That is represented as a ones and zeros. Okay. So here it represents the number of independent symbols. The number of independent symbols that can be carried through a system, the number of independent symbols that can be carried through a system, and it is can be considered as given is unit of time. That will be represented as in a unit of time. So that already I told you, the most basic symbol used to represent the information in the information capacity is bit. The information capacity is bits. So the information capacity of a system which is measured in terms of BPS, that is bits per second, that is represented as a bits per second. Okay, that is will be represented as the information capacity. Once again, I'm telling you, the information capacity is a measure of how much information. The information capacity is measure of how much information which can be propagated through a communication system. That particular information is will be represented as in terms of two functions, such as first one is the bandwidth. The second one is represented as a transmission time. Okay, So that means the transmission time is, let us consider the transmitter and the receiver, the transmitter and receiver. So the transmitter and receiver, it is a short distance. It is a short distance. It takes less transmission time. It is a long distance. It will take high time, more time. That means it is a short distance. It will be connection oriented. That is a guided transmission. Guided transmission. That means the guided transmission means there is a physical path which will be connected between these two systems. That is from the transmitter and receiver. Okay. So whenever the information which needs to be propagated for a long distance, it is not possible to communicate between the transmitter to receiver. Not communication means there is no possibility to arrange a transmission medium between the transmitter to receiver. So that here, what we will do is, at that time, the entire information, at that time, the entire information which is propagated through the free space, propagated to the free space. But what we will occur means, whenever the information which is propagated in the short distance, the internal noise may be occurred. The internal noise is occurred. Okay. So whenever the information which is propagated between the transmitter to receiver for a long distance, then external noise may be added. Okay. So the information which is propagated for a long distance, at that time, the more noise will be added to the original information at the time of the propagating information in the free space. At the time of the propagating the information in the free space. Okay. So at that time, the information, the input data or the propagated information is required more capacity to dominate whatever the unwanted information which is added to the original information from the free space. So that the information capacity is a measure of how much information which can be propagated through a given communication channel. That is depends upon the capacity of the information. Okay. It will dominate whatever the information which is added from the other side. Okay. So it can that at that time the information capacity it will have two functions. That is the information which is combined with two functions. The first one is the bandwidth, and the second one is represented as a transmission time. Depends upon the bandwidth. So how the information which is propagated there, the status of the transmission will be identified. Okay. Based on that, how much time is required to reach the information at the receiver from the transmitter, whether it may be a connection oriented or connectionless, whatever it may be. Okay. Whether it may be a connection oriented or connectionless, whatever it may be. Okay. So that the information capacity is, okay, which is a function of both bandwidth as well as the transmission time. Okay. So it represents the number of independent symbols. Okay. Like comma, colon, bracket, any special characters. Okay. Independent symbols that can be carried through a system in a given unit of time. Okay. So at that time, the most basic symbol which is used or represents the information in the form of a binary digits. Okay. So binary digits means what? The information which is in the form of ones and zeros. Okay. So then this information capacity, which is measured in terms of bits per second, that is very, very important for a short questions. That is for 4 marks. That is information capacity. Okay. Then the information capacity, which will be represented as two ways. The first way is Hartley's law. The second one is Shannon theorem. Okay. both Hartley as well as Dashanan, so both are the scientists. Okay, they measure the information capacity, okay, in different ways. Okay, so according to Hartley's law, how the information capacity is measured. Okay, so all what I am telling in previous case, the information capacity is a measure of how much information that can be propagated through a communication system, and it is function of bandwidth and transmission time. So according to Hartley's law, there he follows the same definition, so that I is directly proportional to B into T. I is directly proportional to B into T. Okay, so the information capacity is directly proportional to the product of bandwidth and time, where I represents the information capacity. Already we have discussed just now, that is bits per second. B is bandwidth, it will be measured in terms of hertz. Then T is transmission time, that will be measured. Time is always measured in terms of the seconds, in terms of the seconds. Okay, so that what we will do is, so from this above equation, the information capacity is a linear function of bandwidth. The information capacity is a linear function of bandwidth and transmission time, whatever we have discussed in this equation, and it is directly proportional to both bandwidth as well as the transmission time. Okay, this is Hartley's law for information capacity, for the information capacity. Okay, the second one is Shannon theorem, that is Shannon Hartley theorem. The information capacity, which is represented as, is if either bandwidth or transmission time. Remember, previous what I am considering bandwidth and transmission time, but here what we discuss a bandwidth or transmission time. Okay, not both, either one. Okay, either bandwidth or transmission time we need to consider, so that if either bandwidth or a transmission time changes, then a proportionality which is occurred for the information capacity as per Shannon Hartley's theorem, the information capacity, where C means capacity, here capacity for information. Okay, so the C equal to B into log of 1 plus S by N base 2. B into log of 1 plus S by N 2, where C is represented as the channel capacity or information capacity. Already we know that is measured in terms of bits per second. Then B is bandwidth of the channel, that is expressed in terms of hertz. S is the total received signal power over the bandwidth. S is the total received signal power over the bandwidth. Okay, so this is, whenever we are called as there is a power, automatically the units for the power is watts. Okay, so N is, already we know that N is the total noise or interference from the other. Okay, interference power over the bandwidth. Okay, this is also measured in terms of watts. Finally, what is meant by S by M? Signal to noise ratio. Okay, so the signal to noise ratio is a linear power ratio. Okay, it is not as a logarithmic decibels. So whenever we are considering as a logarithmic decibels, we get consider the another formula, that is in terms of a decibels, so that basically the information capacity will be represented as per Shannon Hartley theorem, that is C equal to B into log of 1 plus S by N. Okay, so next one is very, very important bits for 2 marks. What is meant by bit? What is meant by bitrate? What is meant by bird? These are the three important definitions. First one is bit, the second one is bitrate, the third one is bird. Okay, bit means, just now I am telling you, the binary information we are considering as the zeros and ones. Okay, but in the information capacity, the most basic information or the basic symbol which is used to represent the information is called as bit, which is called as a bit. The most basic symbol is used to represent the information is called as bit, where in case of information capacity. Okay, then what is meant by bitrate? What is meant by bitrate? See, bitrate basically considering as at the time of modulating the signal, at the time of modulating the signal. Okay, so that the bitrate is defined as the rate of change, the rate of change, the information at the input to the modulator, input to the modulator is called as bitrate. Okay, input means message signal, that is a low frequency signal. Whenever the input signal which is processed, through the channel, at the time of the modulator, the rate it will be changes at the beginning to the modulator, so that the rate of change, at the input to the modulator, which is called as bitrate, okay. So that bitrate, it will be measured in terms of, the bits per second, so that simply the bitrate, which is defined as the rate of change at the input to the modulator, is called as bitrate, So it will be the units for the bitrate is bits per second. The unit for bitrate is a bits per second. Okay. Next one is bird. The next one is represented as a bird. Okay. So bird is represented as, the rate of change, at the output of the modulator, which is called as bird, okay. These three are, see here, input to the modulator, where in case of bitrate, input to the modulator, but whereas in the case of here, the bird, output of the modulator, that is represented as bird. Okay, so bit means the most basic symbol is used to represent the information is called as bit. The most basic symbol is used to represent the information is called bit. The bitrate, in the sense, the rate of change at the input to the modulator is called bitrate. It has units of bits per second. Then bird, the rate of change at the output of the modulator is called bird. Okay, that is bit, bitrate, and bird. These are the three basic definitions in case of transmitting the information from the transmitter to receiver. Okay, then we are going to discuss about very important topic, that is MRA encoding technique, that is called as a MRA encoding technique. Okay, see here, M represents digit, that digit represents possibilities, combinations, conditions, levels. Possibilities, conditions, levels, okay, represent as a digit. Okay, so what is the use of the MRA encoding technique? What is the use of the MRA encoding technique? So that the MRA encoding technique, the MRA encoding technique, which is used to encode the information other than the binary level. Binary means up to only two combinations, either 0 or 1, or 1 or 0, 1 or 0. So that the MRA encoding technique, which is used to encode the information other than the binary level, so that M simply a digit, that is capital M, simply a digit, that digit represents the number of conditions, comma, levels or combinations for a given number of binary variable, that is MRA encoding, that is represented as a MRA encoding. What is the advantage of MRA encoding technique? What is the need of MRA encoding technique? Okay, here the advantage of the MRA encoding technique is whenever the information is higher than the binary level, that is ones and zeros, so at that time, whenever it is necessary to encode that particular information, it is not possible to encode the information other than the MRA encoding technique. So that whenever the information which is other than binary level, which needs to encode at that time, the MRA encoding technique which is used to encode the information. So that the MRA encoding technique which is used to encode the information other than the binary level, that means where more than two conditions are possible, for example, we are taking as M equal to 4, that means four possible conditions. Then the four possible conditions means 00 01 10 11. How we'll get the number of conditions here, that is represented as by using this formula, if a digital signal is given under a four conditions such as voltage, frequency, phase and amplitude, so that will be represented as M equal to 4. So that the number of bits which are necessary to produce a given number of conditions, which are expressed in the mathematical formula is, that is N equal to log M base 2, where N represents how many number of bits are necessary, so that N is the number of bits are necessary. Then M represents number of conditions, levels, combinations, okay, which are possible with the N number of bits, okay. Then from the above equation, that is this one, can be rearranged as, that will be simplified as M equal to 2 power N. Now substitute the values of N equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay. We'll get the value of M. Okay. Let us consider, we'll take the value of N equal to 2. That is 2 square. So that means 2 square means 4. So that M equal to 4. So that For n equal to 2, we'll get m equal to 4, four possible conditions. So this is the basic formula. 2 power n equal to m, for values of n equal to 1, we'll get m equal to 2. N equal to 2, we'll get m equal to 4. Okay. Similarly, n equal to 3, 2 cube. That is 2 cube means 8. So that n equal to 3, m equal to 8. N equal to 4, m equal to 16. N equal to 5, m equal to 32. Okay. These are the number of output. These are the number of output conditions possible for a several values of n. Okay. The several values of n as shown in the above, that is n equal to 1, n equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on, infinity. Wherever how much value we require, that is depends upon the data. We need to substitute those number of values, n values, in this equation. We'll get the number of conditions. Okay. That is MRA encoding technique. Okay. So coming to next one is digital modulation. Already we have analog modulation. What is the necessity we need to go for the digital modulation technique? So in the analog modulation technique, there are some disadvantages are there. To overcome the disadvantages, we can go for digital modulation. But how we can identify whether the modulation is a digital modulation or analog modulation? That is depends upon the nature of the, message signal. In both analog modulation as well as the digital modulation, digital modulation technique, the carrier signal is continuous in nature, but whereas in the case of the message signal is changes. In case of analog modulation, both message and carrier signals are continuous in nature. But in the case of the digital modulation technique, the message signal is digital, the carrier signal is analog signal. That is represented as the digital modulation. Okay. So how to identify, how to consider whether it is a digital modulation or analog modulation means that is depends upon the nature of the modulating signal. If the modulating signal is a continuous signal, that is analog modulation. The modulating signal is the digital signal, then that is represented as the digital modulation. Okay. So that, what is the advantages of digital modulation over the analog modulation means? Okay. So by taking the digital modulation, the advantages are easy of processing, easy of multiplexing, and noise immunity. These are the advantages of the digital modulation. Once again, I'm telling you, the advantages of the digital modulation over the analog modulation system is represented as easy of processing, easy of multiplexing, okay, reduction of noise, okay, that is a noise immunity, okay. So that one more advantage in the digital modulation is the transmission speed is also high in case of a digital modulation when compared to analog modulation technique. Those are the advantages. So then what are the applications of the digital modulation is, that is the applications is the low speed voice data. Okay. So the low speed voice data in the sense, okay, that can be considered in personal communication system. communication system. That is one of the application. The second one is high speed data transmission system. High speed data transmission system. This type of high speed data transmission system, which is used as in the broadband connections. In the broadband connections. The next one is digital satellite communication systems. In the digital satellite communication systems, in the digital satellite communication systems, this digital modulation is preferred. Digital modulation is preferred. Then the next one is personal communication systems. So already we know that the personal communication system is the cellular telephone. The personal communication system is a cellular telephone. Okay, these are the applications of this particular digital modulation system. Okay, see here, these are the different digital modulation output waveforms. Like the digital modulations are ASK, FSK, PSK, amplitude shift keying, phase shift keying, and frequency shift keying. Okay, see, amplitude shift, phase shift, frequency shift. Here, what is the output wave difference in the output waveforms of in both analog and digital means the output will be shift based upon the input digital data. Based upon the input digital data. But whereas in the case of the analog modulation technique, that particular parameter will be varies, that is high value or low value, that is depends upon the message signal. But here depends upon the value digital information from the message signal, it will shift the that particular signal, shift the signal. So that this is amplitude shift keying. Here the input will be changes so that it will shift. For that means here for the logic one, the output is high. For logic one, the output, the logic zero, the output is zero. See here, this is one, so that the entire output is high. This is zero. Again, the entire input output is zero. This is again logic one, the entire output is high. Okay. But very similarly, in the case of the PSK also, the phase shifts will be occurred. Whenever the input is changes, the output is also changes. That means the simple statement in the digital modulation technique is every change in the input, every change in the input, there is a change occurs in the output. There is a change occurs in the output. Okay. That is represented as a digital modulation system. Digital modulation system. Okay. So in the digital modulation system, first of all, let us consider the first method is amplitude shift keying. The first one is a amplitude shift keying. We'll discuss the amplitude shift keying in the next class. Okay. So disconnect ayin tarvata malli andaru join avandi attendance teeskunta. So this is digital modulation. In the digital modulation means the identification of the digital modulation is that is depends upon the message signal. That is nature of the message signal. Okay. So when the digital modulation is considered, when the digital modulation is considered, the nature of the message signal is digital signal and the carrier signal is continuous signal only. Okay, so what is the need, what is the advantage of this particular digital modulation means? So the advantages of the digital modulation or the analog modulation system is easy of processing, easy of multiplexing, high transmission speed, and the reduction of the noise. And the reduction of the noise, these are the various advantages of the digital modulation over the analog modulation system. Over the analog modulation system, the applications are low speed voice data, high speed data transmission system, digital satellite communication system, personal communication system. Personal communication system, these are the applications. First one is low speed voice data. Second one is high speed data transmission system. The third one is the satellite communication system. Then the third one is personal communication system. Okay. Now these are the input and output waveforms for digital modulation schemes like ASK, FSK, and VSK. This is ASK for logic 1, the output is 9. Logic 0, the output is 0. Again, logic 1, the output is high. Okay. So these are the corresponding waveform ASK, VSK, and the FSK. Okay. These are the different output waveforms, not different output waveforms for only.